The second known live case of Craniopagus Parasiticus was a full 220 years later, a few months before Manar was born. Rebecca Martinez was born in December 2003 in the Dominican Republic. Rebecca's case provides vital information for Professor Lotvi. When Rebecca was 8 weeks old, surgery took place in the capital to remove her parasitic twin. In charge of the operative team was Dr. Jorge Lazarev, director of pediatric neurosurgery at UCLA.
I always emphasize that it is very important that the physicians from the developing nations overcome the colonial complex, that everything good that can be done or everything that is difficult can only be done in Los Angeles, New York, or London. And that they say, no, okay, we have the elements, we have the knowledge, and we can do it in here.
The operation lasted 11 hours. During that time, Rebecca's blood was replaced 2.5 times, a standard amount.
Our major challenge, as the challenge with any neonatal or baby or infantile surgery, is the amount of blood loss and how well you control it. The more blood that you transfuse, the you decrease the coagulation capabilities of the transfused blood.
Rebecca left surgery alive and stable. An excited medical team announced the result to the world's press.
Pero sí nos está dejando una experiencia extraordinaria. Se ha hecho el primer caso en la historia del mundo.
But 7 hours later, Rebecca died. Although the neurosurgery was a success, Rebecca had started to hemorrhage at the wound and had to have more blood. Her young liver couldn't produce enough clotting agents for the new blood to heal the wound, and she bled to death.
Todos saben que Rebequita falleció. Eso es lo primero. Nosotros estamos tranquilos.
I assume, that the best thing for me is to actually say, okay, we lost more blood than we should have lost it, and thus, if that issue would have been solved, then she probably would be alive.
Yes, we can separate the right side of...
Rebecca's operation, the one and only on a Craniopagus parasiticus before Manar, may have failed, but it taught Professor Lotvi some important lessons.
I know that as regards the prognosis in the literature is gloomy, but I became very attached to Manar, emotionally connected with her. And I hope to rescue Manar.
10-month-old Manar is slowly dying, and the operation is her only hope. But separating the two brains means certain death for her twin. And in Islam, that's a moral decision as well as a medical one.
You have to think twice and three times and four times, and especially if it is life and death. You are deciding about another person.
Like any mother told that she will lose her child, I felt very sad and I would cry.
The operation will kill the parasitic twin, but Manar is also at risk. If she survives, she will make medical history. In Egypt, 11-month-old Manar is in a critical condition. Her heart's failed 6 times, and if she isn't separated from her parasitic twin, she will die. Her twin has a fully developed head and a fully formed brain. She's even capable of reflex actions like blinking, suckling, and crying. But she has no body and no other vital organs. If separated, she will die. The operation is urgent, but the surgeon in charge, Professor Lotvi, is worried about the ethical problem it poses.
You must have the legal opinion and the religious opinion. I want to do the surgery in peace, not thinking of what will happen to me after the surgery.
Professor Lotfi turns to the Grand Mufti for guidance. As the top authority on legal and ethical matters in Sunni Islam, the Mufti's word on whether the operation should go ahead will be final.
In Islam, we look at each case in terms of the whole. We do not look at it from one side only.
Two days later, the Mufti comes back with his decision.
In this case, we consider it the lesser of two evils. Could the sacrifice of the second weaker child save the life of the stronger one? And it's common sense for anyone, because who would choose the greater danger over the smaller one?
He answered me, it is right, you can go for, because you are choosing the less harmful thing. Because if you didn't do the surgery, there is more harm. The two persons may die. But if I did the surgery, I may rescue one person. So I do the surgery.
With the approval of Egypt's most prominent cleric, the doctors schedule the operation to separate Manar and her twin for February the 18th, 2005.
The week before the operation, I didn't sleep. I would stay up and read the Quran. I was constantly worried. They told me the other half was going to die, and I plucked up the courage to sign the consent form. I thought this is a test from God, and I have to get through this, because this is something big for any human.
Today, after 11 months fighting for her life, Manar will be separated from her parasitic twin. The only previous operation like it failed. The world's media has been tipped off about the operation and has descended on Benha, 48 kilometers north of Cairo.
I knew how big and important Manar's operation would be in the Middle East. A journalist overheard us talking about what day we were operating, and he informed all the TV stations.
I said to Dr. Nasif, please, Dr. Nasif, don't contact the media. In the morning, I found in the newspaper that Dr. Lotfi is going to do today a surgery of Craniopagus Parasiticus in Benha.
Well, when I realized what the publicity would be, I decided to connect a live video link to the operation for the press to watch it.
When I reached the hospital, I find the TV, Egyptian TV, the NBC, the Reuters and the CNN, all the media are present there, and this is a very stressful situation. I felt that I'm going in a war. There is something which very heavy on my heart and my brain. And I was saying to myself, please God, aid me in doing this job.
Manar's family are gathered in a separate room. The operation will mean the certain death of Manar's parasitic twin. And even if Manar survives the operation, she is at risk of brain damage.
The hospital had warned me that if anything happened to her, I would be the first to hear. And they said she could die.